I'm Ben.
I'm sorry.
If you would like to get your song reviewed, dear listener, there's the Filthy Capitalist option. As Sori says, 125 gets you straight to the head of the line. You don't have to be a part of the alliance. You don't have to be part of the group.
Wait a minute.
And the biggest thing is you don't have to wait. You hop, skip, and jump right in front of everybody. 125 gets you there. You do that 3 times and then get mashed down to the $75 rate for perpetuity.
Yes!
Also, there is a band review option. So if you've got a band and you're trying to get your band some exposure, hit me up at insori@gmail.com and I'll show you the details about how to pull
you
that off.
You can also jump on Patreon and there is a option on the tiers to be able to get your band reviewed. Yep. Obviously, we can't lie to you, so we can't guarantee a positive review. Get what you get.
It's just rubbish.
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 That's British for garbage.
My favorite is a community option. $1 at the gate gets you into Patreon. You get to join an alliance. The alliance joins their points together, and that helps determine what songs that we do.
The alliances hang out on Discord.
Shh, message me on Patreon to get the link.
And they do all kinds of other cool things. They do Minecraft. What? Dungeons and Dragons.
Yeah. It's really a community within the community. Anybody can go in the village, facebook.com/VinandSori. There's 160,000+ people on the channel. What's cool about the Discord is that it offers a real opportunity for community, connection, friendship, that type of thing.
And it's on Discord, so if you're not a Facebook person, it's for you.
You start off at $1.
Right.
Plus you get exclusives. Sori and I are working on a song. So the first 15 seconds of that was on Patreon. Also, at $15 tier and above, when we actually debut the video, they're going to be there live with us. There you are, dear listener.
Buy our merch.
Buy our merch indeed.
Parasite Eve is next, everybody. We are in the middle of a DJ stream for the big homie Chad. Shout out to him. And if you'll notice, this is his little symbol in the corner.
Yes, sir. I'm assuming the big homie Chad is a Tool fan.
I'm assuming that as well.
We have to assume that. You know what happens when you assume. This, ladies and gents, is a little band called Bring Me the Horizon.
And the song is Parasite.
Shout out to all the dislikers. We got 2 immediately. Every night there's a competition between the likers and the dislikers. Right now it's 28-3. The likers are in the lead, but the dislikers...
Smash that like button, please.
I'm a disliker, so
Ben wants
smash
dislikes and I
smash,
want likes.
Smash the dislike button. If you are a fan of black metal, there is a black metal alliance. I don't know if we're allowed to say the name of the black metal alliance.
No, jump on Patreon and send me a message.
Yeah, because they're a super secret alliance, and we're about to do a DJ stream for them pretty soon.
Also, when we do the DJ stream, if you guys request corpse paint, that might happen. You have to request it.
That may happen. However, Bring Me the Horizon, Parasite Eve, lyrics are in the song itself. Let's go.
Sounds like it sounds like
Enigma.
Attack on Titan.
Yeah, Attack on Titan, yeah. Is this the right song? I got a
fever, don't breathe on me. Did you use his link? Nobody won't let me leave because I've seen something. Hope I don't sneeze, I don't. Really, we just need to feel something. Only pretending to feel something. I know you're dying to run. I wanna turn you around. Ooh. Please remain calm. The end has arrived. We cannot see you. Enjoy the ride. This is the moment you've been waiting for. Don't call it a warning. This is a war. It's a parasite.
Whoa.
Wow. I'm liking it. I heard they need better signal. Put your pins in the needles. Quarantine all of those secrets in that black hole you call a brain before it's too late. Really, we just want to scream something. Only pretend to believe something. I know you're baying for blood. I want to turn you around. Please remain calm. The end has arrived. We
am.
You can board up your windows. Woo-hoo. You can lock up your doors, yeah. But you can't keep washing your hands of this shit anymore. When all the kings tossed and then all the kings freeze, don't know the answer from their paper jets. When life is a prison and death is a door, they say you want it. This is a...
Oh! Okay, let's go. Let's go, DJ Chad, let's go!
Wow!
When did this song come out?
Backwards, you know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like that song.
I think this is the first song that's directly addressing the pandemic, huh?
Is that what it is?
I mean, I'm assuming, I'm looking at the date, June 25th, 2020, so it fits, right?
Yeah.
I just don't know if that's specifically, but it looks like, yeah, so Chris is saying the same thing. The lyrics of the song gives me COVID vibes. Chris, are you the guy that sent me the email with the title Filthy Capitalist in it?
Alright, well, I'm pulling up the lyrics. I'll tell you what,
okay.
I loved
so,
that line.
Yeah, Parasite Eve, I was pretty certain, like, it was directly referencing COVID, I think. And I think...
You're probably right.
Lyrically, I appreciate the hell out of it because...
Oh, yeah.
Art should... Art should reflect what's going on in the world around you, right?
I know you're dying to run. I want to turn you around. What's that supposed to be?
Okay, so I've got the lyrics here, so we can all break them down together, shall we? This guy Chad is a deep brother, apparently.
Yeah.
And I can't believe we missed it. I can't believe that this song isn't like a major.
Are okay. All their songs like this?
Who, Bring Me the Horizon?
Yeah, I don't remember hearing anything like this before.
No,
we have listened to Bring Me the Horizon,
right? This is a completely different style. I thought we got the wrong song. Like,
so did I. I was clicking around all over the place, and then I followed his link, and I was like, okay, so we didn't get the wrong
song. Like, a minute and a half into it, I finally, like, I had to go and I had to look elsewhere and verify that we had the right song, because it's so different from all the other songs that they've done. And apparently there's a video game called Parasite Eve, but obviously lyrically. Ollie said, while seeming all too relevant to the current coronavirus, the song Parasite Eve actually started to form last year when Sykes was reading about a Japanese superbug. So that's one of those situations that Jung called synchronicity.
Yeah, yes.
Where he was writing about, you know, a superbug or whatever because he'd read it, and then it just so happened that as he's writing the song... Boom, a super bug actually hits. That's probably, you know, so
yep.
It's just very, very serious. Now, Senior Clay is saying that there's all uplifting everyone, an inspirational, uplifting message. I don't know how literal that is, but
I mean, I don't know if
where the hell did the lyrics go?
Okay.
Right here.
So the superbug in the book, or whatever it was, it had become heat resistant due to climate change.
Oh.
Right? So I'm assuming when he says, you know, we're not going to learn the lesson, the lesson would be take care of the planet. Look, you've got this superbug that came as a result of climate change.
Mm-hmm.
But I think now, because reality has hit us with this coronavirus bug, now we're being forced to deal with concepts like, because in this song, the universe of this song is pretty simple. If you would have took care of the planet, then we wouldn't have had this superbug metastasized into something else.
Mm-hmm.
So the message is, take care of the planet, or the planet's going to find, Gaia's going to find some way to take you out. Okay, that's a very simple actual world to live in. It's not mm-hmm. simple to implement, mm-hmm. but the solution is simple. Okay, well, coronavirus is different.
I know, yeah.
Because it is not a simple solution. And that's one of the things that's crazy about coronavirus and the way people act when this subject comes up.
Yep.
Number one, it's called the novel coronavirus, but everybody's a fucking expert. Everybody knows everything about coronavirus. It's unbelievable to me. You know, it's people of a very, very specific persuasion. Y'all know what I'm talking about. And they truly believe that their friend in their basement at some .com blog or whatever, or they'll have some, you know, post that says thetruthrevealed.com, and it's mm-hmm. like some guy in his basement.
Mm-hmm.
And they will look at that and say, that, there you go.
Yep.
Because they're used to, hey, if I see something on TV, somebody speaking authoritatively, obviously they can't lie. So all these websites are cropping up with all these crazy ideas and theories about coronavirus. And people are like,
it's crazy.
Literally risking their lives and dying based on this falsified information.
And the thing is,
so it's not as simple as like, oh, we're doing global warming and we created the superbug and we need to start taking care of the planet. Like, the message is a lot more intricate than that.
Yeah. Well, and it's, the whole thing is so complicated because there's so much like lying and dishonesty, and then like you said, people are not listening to experts. They're listening to, you know, what they read in a post on YouTube or on Facebook or whatever, and it's, I don't know. It's a terrible thing, and I'm,
go ahead.
I kind of feel like it's like a sick thing to say, but I'm tired of seeing people die about it. You know what I mean? Like, and that's like,
yeah.
What do you mean you're tired of seeing people? Well, you see what I mean? Like, it like makes think and feel horrible things. Like,
yeah.
And when you go out at the store and stuff, like it almost feels like everybody's a little unclear as to what we should be doing here. So before,
well, that's the thing. Like, so like, for example, I'm watching Tom Brady. I commented about this.
Yes,
I was watching Tom Brady yesterday at the press conference, and he's there physically,
mm-hmm.
and members of the press are there, and Tommy didn't have a mask on. Lamar Jackson had a mask on, but Tom didn't,
mm-hmm.
and Tom is the one that's famous for spending $2 million a year on his body.
Mm-hmm.
Right. I guess Tom took the vaccine. I'm not sure. I mean, the entire Bucks organization. Honestly, the Bucks have one of the highest vaccine totals, and I think it's because of Tom. Because everybody knows how much Tom spends on his body. So the logic is, Tom would not put this in his body mm-hmm. if
he hadn't have done the research, and yeah.
The problem with that thinking is, wait a second, Tom Brady is pathological in his competitive drive. And so I believe he would risk that. I believe he would risk his life to be able to play this season, win the Super Bowl, and go for a perfect record. So, me personally, yeah. The fact that Tom's doing that, that doesn't convince me that it's safe. Okay, now for full disclosure, I'm already vaccinated, so is she. Now, we took the vaccine long ago, but my point is, we did the double one. The fact that Tom Brady did it doesn't mean that it's okay in my mind. Because Tom Brady is, I think he's pathological. I think there's something wrong with him. We're celebrating it because we benefit off of his pathology. But something is wrong with him. Like, I believe he would risk his life to play this game. So the fact that he does it doesn't indicate to me in any way, shape, or form that it's safe.
Yeah, but does he have to take the vaccine to play?
Well, what happens is you could end up forfeiting. Like the way they have the rules in the NFL, oh, like it's one of those things, okay, where like you have a choice, but you don't really have a choice. And I believe that they're going for an undefeated season. That's what I believe. Mike Evans let it slip yesterday. He says, we think we can do something special with this offense. And the last time I've heard a Tom Brady team say that, it was 2007, long story short. But my point is, everybody who's trying to pretend that this is some easy thing, like, I understand why my friends are not vaccinating. I get it.
Oh, I do too.
You're telling people to put something in their body they have no idea about. On top of that, the main talking head that was supposed to guide us through it, Mr. Fauci,
was lying to us.
Well, on top of lying to us, may be the very reason we have coronavirus in the first place, all the gain of function research, which we will never know. But none of us, if it came out tomorrow, we have definitive, undeniable evidence that Fauci was one of the main players that created corona in the first place. None of us would be surprised. Fauci came on, lied to us, told us not to wear masks, and then he came and told us that he told us that because he wanted to make sure all the healthcare workers had the mask first, so they lied to us and told us not to wear them. So people died because of that. So
yeah, why wouldn't he say, if that was what his plan was, why wouldn't he say, masks are extremely important, but they're actually better if you use cotton rather than those masks. So, you know, cut up your whatever and tie, you know what I'm saying? Like, why wouldn't he do that where it was still giving some people some protection? Why say that you don't need it at all? So that way, you know what I'm saying? Like, couldn't he have just used a little bit of intellect and twisted that story so people would have put something for a mask, but they wouldn't have wanted the disposables?
Yeah, but people like that have spent so much time in the ivory tower that they look at other people as almost like their children, almost like infants. So they don't feel the need to do all that kind of thinking. They just say, oh yeah, let's do this, and people generally just follow them along.
Yeah.
And so my thing is, like, with COVID, it's like we're demonizing each other and pretending that the other side does not have serious, legitimate concerns mm-hmm. about what's happening. Mm-hmm. And then there's the other angle of the government. Look, and, you know, it's really ironic hearing Republicans use the my body, my choice argument. I was talking to Donna. I made the mistake of commenting because I just couldn't take it. But Donna was saying, basically, my body, my choice.
Away.
And I'm like, holy shit, we've come full. This person,
wow.
I shouldn't even have said her name because people could find her. Like, she's... The irony of Republicans saying that, or right, or conservatives saying my body, my choice, is unbelievable.
Mm-hmm.
It's unbelievable.
Mm-hmm.
And
wow.
But at the same time, the irony of leftists saying no, not your body, your choice. Both sides don't see the irony. It's mind-boggling to me because now you got leftists saying, yeah, your personal body autonomy ends when you put another person's life in danger. I agree. I agree. So there is a lesson. There is a certain lesson that coronavirus is teaching both sides.
Yes.
So if you're a conservative,
facts.
If you're a conservative and you hear the my body, my choice line, don't be so quick to dismiss it. Don't be so quick to dismiss it. And if you're a leftist and you can't stand how selfish those my body, my choices are, I agree with you to a degree, but fill in the blank. There is a lesson that this whole coronavirus is teaching us, for sure.
Yep.
For sure. But man,
I think lyrically, I definitely agree with you. It looks like it's obviously about that, not coronavirus, but that it was about something, and it has those along the same lines. I also thought that the message was important for. Where it said, where did it say about the
I've said that Fauci should be brought up at the Hague. I really believe that for crimes against humanity. I
you
really
think
do.
What?
Fauci. I believe he should be brought up to The Hague.
Oh.
The Hague is where they took the Nazis and did war tribunals.
Oh, I totally agree. You lied to all of us, and there are so many people dead because of
that. Well, as Tasco's saying, he put a link on MA about Fauci. He funded 30 different lab studies in Wuhan. He reversed the Obama ban on gain-of-function research, lied to Congress twice, lied about masks. Dude should be in prison. Yeah, and that's why it says, I'm a believer in nobody. Mm-hmm. I'm a believer in nobody.
That's so wrong.
And now when you have these people and they're conspiracy theorists, I get it. Like, to a degree, some of these conspiracy theorists are, you're just weird, man. Some of these people are really, really weird. I get it.
But let somebody have some drug on them that they shouldn't have, but not even enough to be weighed and that person's in jail. But he's doing all this?
Right. And the larger issue, though, is, dude, we've got over a million people dead all over the planet. We've got close to you can round up a million people in the next 6 months in America. And you did all this. You did all this.
That's
shit.
You.
And there's no accountability for you. And then you got other people looking at this shit and saying, "Well, I don't believe what you tell me to do." Well, yeah. What do you mean injected? Man, fuck you. I'm not listening to you.
Oh, I know.
You can't call those people crazy. Mm-mm. You can't say those people are conspiracy theorists. You know, what's his face? John, got on the show and he was like, it's called the Wuhan coronavirus lab. It's like, the shit is crazy. And then you got Joe Rogan. Jimmy's been covering this. You got Joe Rogan. Joe Rogan got corona and then he got like some weird ivermectin, whatever prescription. And now he's better. Mm-hmm. Now, again, the same thing with Tom Brady. So Jimmy's like, yo, look, Joe Rogan got a lot better. He got a lot better a lot quicker. Joe Rogan is, again, another one of these guys that's famous for being maniacal about taking care of his body and about exercising and about cardiovascular work and doing 2 days and sometimes 3 days. So, yes, if Joe Rogan contracts corona, I can see that a guy like him would get over it very quickly with little or no, you know, symptomatic, you know, duress. So, it's just such a complicated situation because people, you have statistical data and then you have anecdotal data. Then you've got Nicki Minaj saying, oh, this guy took it. He took the vaccine and his testicles were swelling or whatever. Like, there's this other thing. So now Nicki Minaj is getting, like, not canceled, but, like, you know, censored or whatever. And it's just a giant fucking mess, man. When you combine... You know what's interesting is that when you say something on the internet and then a whole bunch of people watch it, they call it going viral. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I think that that's one of the craziest things about this situation is that pandemics and plagues have always been part of human history, but the combination of pandemics and social media, because of the misinformation and disinformation and the capability for destruction, is something we've never seen before and we've never had a dress rehearsal for. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you see Facebook every single time somebody says anything about COVID, positive or negative, they have that little thing in there. I understand why they're doing that. They're like, holy shit, we've never been in this situation in human history before. So I'm glad that they did the song. It's an extremely difficult topic to navigate, man. Like, Joe Rogan took mono... Xionio, I don't even know what that is. Antibodies that cost over $2,000 per prescription. Holy shit. Wow.
Okay.
I mean, $2,000 per prescription.
Hopefully that's not necessary. The rest of us are screwed.
I mean, again, this just exposed. That's what I'm saying. Like, this plague has exposed so many things. Like, for example, in America, when you're sick, you're encouraged to come to work sick. Mm-hmm. And when I say encouraged, I mean encouraged in the way that the mafia encourages you by giving you an offer you can't refuse. Mm-hmm. Because you cannot live in America if you call out of work because you're sick. Well, when you have that kind of societal structure and then you have a plague like corona, it is perfect for the spreading of corona. So if you don't take that lesson and apply it in the future, then you're not getting the point. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like this thing in the Old Testament where God's like, you got to give the land a Sabbath, meaning stop working the thing to death every 7 years. So every 7 years, you kind of had to, like, just let the land breathe. Mm-hmm. And then, because you were supposed to rest. But then Yahweh said, if you guys don't listen, the land is going to vomit you out. So Yahweh personifies the land as if the land itself were conscious and said, I don't want these people around me anymore because these people are not living the way they should.
They're toxic.
So the land vomits you out because you're toxic. And so it's like, oh, think about Corona. Which demographic got hit the most with Corona? It was a demographic that benefited from Medicare, but did not want to give Medicare to the younger generation. And sure enough, the demographic that was most affected, and when I say most affected, I mean killed by this virus, was that specific demographic. You've got a culture, an economic system that encourages people to work in the slave sweatshop no matter how sick you are. Mm-hmm. Which then is the reason that the thing spread so efficiently in mm-hmm. this country. Like, then you've got people that have severe healthcare issues that if they don't get fixed, they will spread to other people. But because they don't have health insurance, that happened. So there's so many, like, things where I'm just saying, okay, you can look at it from a purely naturalistic perspective and say, well, holy shit, this is just a bad mm-hmm. kind of phase in the human experience. Or you can look at this as some sort of karmic, sort of almost Gaian idea of
warning
of the earth is fighting against you.
Yeah.
The earth is fighting back against you. And I'm mm-hmm. saying this as a person that has lost and wept over people in this disease mm-hmm. and has a parent that's in a severe danger. It's the only parent I have left in a severe danger zone in a horrible place in Florida for coronavirus. But it's almost as if, you know, nature itself is saying, okay, motherfuckers, mm-hmm. okay, you guys want to yep. do this? Okay, let's see. You yep. know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah.
The part where it said, when we forget the infection, will we remember the lesson? I think that pertains, obviously, to what we've been talking about all along. But I also think that that's a good thing for us, for everything. Like, when you're a child and you get in trouble and you're living under the punishment that you've so rightly deserved, like, how quickly after that do you forget? You know what I mean? Like, if you, well, that was not that big a deal, then you repeat those actions as a child. And I think that as adults, we can find ourselves doing the same thing. Like, you landed in X, Y, and Z situation. Okay, you landed in a bad relationship, and the guy was abusive, but you keep finding those same types of people. That's not the only type of guy that's out there. That's not the only type of girl that's out there.
Right.
So you learn the lesson from the infection.
Uh-huh.
And it's not just relationships, it's jobs, it's everything that you do. There is lessons that we're learning every single day, how we treat each other. Right. So are we going to learn the lesson from the infection, or are we just going to keep right on going? So I just, you know, God, let me learn the lesson. Anyway. Let me learn the lesson, please. Yeah. Please, God. Anyway, this song is a 10 for me. This was wicked good. I loved it.
It's an 11 for me. I think it's a different adjective, but I'll just use it. I've just been disappointed in a lot of, like, when you look at music from the 60s and the 70s, even the 80s, especially hip hop in the 80s, it just felt like a lot of the artists were
intentional.
You could tell what was going on in that time period just looking at the artists. Whether the movies they wrote, yeah. the books they wrote, the music yeah. they wrote, and I don't know, I just feel like that's been gone. And for these guys, first of all, this doesn't sound like anything like this band at all, number one. And number two, I don't see, let's say it this way, the lessons that need to be learned from coronavirus and the conversations that we need to have about this, whatever we want to call this thing, I think the artists could really help us get through this thing. Because art functions in that area where there isn't a hard left, a hard right, a black and white.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of grayish. And art is perfect for that kind of mushy category of thought.
Mm-hmm.
And there's so much emotion and passion that goes along with this whole discussion. I just feel like there should be way more artists
talking about this and tackling
all the angles to it.
I totally agree.
Shout out to Vlad. And, you know, everybody, look, I believe you should be vaccinated. I believe that there's clear and empirical definitive data that states that the vaccine is better, will do more harm, do more good cumulatively for us than harm. But I have no judgments for you whatsoever. There was an MIT study that recently came out that said that people who don't take the vax are highly informed, highly curious people. In other words, these are not dumb, and these are people who are like, wait a second. And they're using the resources they have available to them on the internet to do it. So I'm not going to stereotype you and say you're a horrible person if you don't vax, okay? Like, if you're not vaxing because you're an informed person and you've done the research, then I respect that. If you're against a vaccine because your friend is against a vaccine or Glenn Beck is against a vaccine or whoever, it doesn't... My opinion of you doesn't matter. What I will say, though, is that you owe it to yourself and the people around you to do a little bit more in-depth research on it.
Right.
If you are vaccinated, great, but the vaccine is not 100% anything. So you should still, you know, we were at the gym and we had a little nice little routine. And then I was sneezing and coughing at Walmart. And, you know, I had to self-quarantine. You know, that's why I haven't been to the gym in a while. But, you know, I'm trying, even though we're vaccinated, we're both double vaccinated. Like, I'm like, I don't believe that if I get corona or she gets corona, I think we'll be okay. We'll be okay. But, I'm worried about, you know, little French Canadian, 80-year-old French Canadian lady that's behind me in line, or the, you know, the cashier or whoever. So I had to kind of pull myself back. So anyway, nobody wants to hear about all the corona shit that we're doing, but there you go. Much love to everybody. Shout out to everybody. Difficult decisions all around, guys. Difficult decisions all around. Let's try to be a little bit more, all of us now, try to be a little bit more of a understanding of each other, and a little less judgmental, and hopefully, inshallah, we can get past this together and learn what we have to learn, ultimately. Mm. That's my concern. Mm-hmm. So there you go. I am triple vaccinated. Holy shit. I'm vaccinated because I cannot afford to get sick. Yeah, that's the other thing. It's like, the other thing is, like, I wonder how many people, like, are basically being extorted.
Yeah.
Because of our financial system to be vaccinated against their will in the first fucking place. I mean, there are so many moving pieces. It takes the wisdom of Solomon to figure all this shit out. So, anyway, the big thing is, be safe, guys. Vin out.
Sorry out.
Gone.